Of my work as an illustrator in the world of food and fashion. To start, I'm going to start also with a little movie, and it's very convenient for me because I'm nervous, so first, pay close attention.
No, and I've seen your dress before.
That's because it's trying to reinvent the driveway, so I
should get all the other dresses.
We have some right here, and then I'm going to I think it can be very interesting.
No. No, it's just baffling to me. Why is it so impossible to put together a decent run through? People have had hours and hours to prepare. It's just so confusing to me. Where are the advertisers?
We have some pieces from Banana Republic.
Well, we need more, don't we? Oh, just this. What do you think?
Yeah. Well, you know me. Give me a full ballerina skirt and a hand of saloon. I'm on board.
Mm. But do you think it's too much like...
I've got a quad from July. I thought that, but no, not with the right accessories. It should work.
Where are the belts for this strap? Why is no one ready?
It's a tough call. They're so different.
Something funny?
No, nothing's, you know, it's just the, both those belts look exactly the same to me, you know, I'm still learning about this stuff and,
This stuff? Oh, okay, I see, you think this has nothing to do with you. You go to your closet and you select, I don't know, that lumpy blue sweater, for instance, because you're trying to tell the world that you take yourself too seriously to care about what you put on your back, but what you don't know is that that sweater is not just blue, it's not turquoise, it's not lapis, it's actually cerulean. And you're also blithely unaware of the fact that in 2002, Oscar de la Renta had a collection of cerulean gowns, and then I think it was Yves Saint Laurent, wasn't it, who showed cerulean military jackets? I think we need a jacket here. And then cerulean quickly showed up in the collections of 8 different designers. It filtered down through the department stores and then trickled on down into some tragic casual corner where you no doubt fished it out of some clearance bin. However, that blue represents millions of dollars and countless jobs. And it's sort of comical how you think that you have a choice that exempts you from the fashion industry when in fact you're wearing a sweater that was selected for you by the people in this room. From a pile of stuff.
So, I can hear you one thing. Well, what the hell does this have to do with food? Before I explain that, I want to explain to you the meaning of showing this little movie clip to you. Fashion starts at a very high level. We have haute couture. And there a trend starts and it goes lower and lower and it changes a bit. And in the end, we wear the stuff and we have it in our own closets and we buy it in the normal stores. So what I think what we can do is that we do the same with food. Trends in food work the same, I think. You can see the plate on the left in haute cuisine starting at a very high level. Other chefs and restaurants get inspired by it, use it, and in the end we can eat the trend in our own on our own plate, and we can buy it even in the supermarket. So if we put those two lines together, you can see that there's a similarity between trends in food and in fashion, and even sometimes the trends in food and fashion are the same. For instance, nowadays we're all very busy on eating flowers, but we also wear flowers in our pants, or the influences from the Nordics, also very important, both in food and fashion. So that's a similarity, and next to the similarity, they also inspire each other. Food inspires fashion, and fashion inspires food. So that's where I work. I work in the middle. The overlap in food and fashion with my illustrations. And for sure, I'm not the first one and the only one who works in that area. For instance, we have Marjan Ippel, a trend watcher from the Netherlands, who says food is fashion. Fashion not in the way of clothing, but fashion in the way of trends. Or this summer, we can all eat fashion at the Culinaire Werkplaats. They have a dinner inspired by Dutch fashion designers, so that's very cool. I'll go and eat there. Dominique Persoon, a chocolatier from Belgium, he already made chocolate dresses, but also chocolate inspired hats. Or these images, very literally, food is fashion, food outfits. These are from Amy Goodhart and a team of designers. Or this one from, I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm going to try, Sun Yun Yu. The food dress is a banana dress and an eggplant dress. Beautiful. Or you can even take your own lettuce umbrella. Maybe a bit too far, but it's funny. And if you're interested in food movies, you should really watch this movie. There are a lot of food movies which you should watch, but this one is especially nice with the costumes from Jean-Paul Gaultier, so it's food and fashion. Okay, now I'm going to talk a little bit about how I became a illustrator and how I went from fashion to food. This is sort of me, my work, not me in the image, but I wish. So how did I become a illustrator? Because fashion designer is a very nice job. I did it for 10 years, and it's very awesome to see your own designs walking in the street, so very nice. But there were already a bit the signs that maybe fashion wasn't the world for me to work in. This is my graduation collection, or the inspiration material. I inspired my collection on color and textures of food, and as you can see, I went very far in it because the color cards all have food names. So it was sign one. Sign two, I had to travel a lot in my work as a food fashion designer, and I wasn't really busy with, well, which collection do I have to see or which store do I have to go, but I was busy with where are we going to eat, what are we going to eat, and when are we going to eat. So my Elle magazine, I didn't read it anymore, but I started to read Elle Eten, Elle Food. And in the middle of the crisis, I thought, well, what the heck, I'm going to quit my job. I'm going to think about what do I want and where am I good at. So I'm good at sketching. I want to work in food, so I'm going to draw food. And then I thought, I want to be a culinary illustrator. Am I the first culinary illustrator? Well, you can say that, but it's more that I'm the first one who names it, who is busy in its specialty. So food illustration was there before photography, and I was very surprised that there are a lot of food photographers, but there are no illustrators who call themselves culinary illustrators. So in that way, I'm the first culinary illustrator in that specialty. But food was always, it was earlier drawn than photographs. So I went even further. So now we're going to make a step from culinary illustrator to illustrator. Well, this was a coincidence because I made a Twitter account En culinary illustrator was too long, so I made culustrator. Okay, so what does a culustrator do? And why is it food and fashion? First, I'm going to show you some examples of more illustration about food, and it will go to fashion. So we end at fashion again. But to start, I had to start with something when I was a illustrator because I didn't have much work. I thought I had my Twitter account. Wow. And I thought, what can I do? I want to Twitter about what I eat, because that's important for a illustrator. But I don't want to do it in words, I want to do it in images. So that was a big success. Every day I Twittered an image, and I got a lot of traffic to my website. Kind of the same I did with my illustrations. I went out a lot for very nice dinners, and I wanted to show everyone how nice it is in a nice restaurant. So I thought, well, I want to do a review, but not in words, again, but in image. So I made up a word, again. it's a Dutch word. It means illustrated restaurant review. So, also a success. So what I think is important, that if you are an illustrator, that you go further than only make a nice picture. For instance, this one, the cupcake trend, I love to draw cupcakes. I can bake them, but I can't draw them. And with only drawing wasn't enough. No, I wanted to do something that people can do something with it. And this is when you can cut it out and you can create your own delicious cupcake. This looks like a normal food tattoo, but I use the tattoos for trend visuals, so it's also sort of a second layer. Not only you can stand out from the rest with your illustrations, you can also create a kind of atmosphere, the right atmosphere. In this project for Harvest Markets on Schiphol, I worked on illustrations on the wall, and it was a concept about healthy food, sustainability, local food. So actually, you have to eat there. Or you don't have to eat there fast, but it's kind of fast food because you're on a airport. Thank you. But it has to be healthy. So here you can see the images which really give you a local and a healthy from the field feeling. And the storytelling in the signing was very important. Also the illustrations again, so it's kind of a communication. Signing is also communication for just saying, what can I get here? And of course, of just selling, very important. Also, very important to sell your food in the stores. Food packaging and illustration, big item. I cannot tell you all about it because it's such a big thing, but I wanted to show you that illustrations in food packaging is really important. Another kind of illustration is the technical food illustrations, or the taste illustrations. It's not so much about being pretty, the illustration, but it's about making something clear, explaining what you mean. For instance, the book Hashtag Sterrenchefs also has these awesome recipes from chefs who write about their recipes, but also, as you can see, use little illustrations to make clear what they mean with the dish. We go a step further. Katie Shelley made a really awesome book, Picture Cook. She uses as little text as possible to explain her dishes. So we should all buy it, I think. Another book you should buy for inspiration is the Hessen Blumenthal book. The illustrations are different because they're not literally food illustrations, but there are pictures that illustrate food. So that's another way of thinking. Very nice. On the internet, the drawing cook, if you want inspiration of how to make a recipe in a different way, you should really visit the website, because there it's very inspirational. People from all over the world make these recipes, and they send it in, and the people from they draw and cook, they place it on the website, and you can all see it. I have to take a little sip of water. Okay. This one. Now we have a little Oprah moment, because you all on your chairs, you all find a card, that's a project of mine, my sustainable card, and sustainable not in the way of materials, but it is sustainable in the way of how you use it. You don't throw away this card, you keep it, you see the QR code inside, you can if you use your phone, you go to my website, and every season you get a new recipe. So I'll keep it and put it on your table. Okay, back to fashion a bit now. Also, I made these illustrations about food, which were inspired by the fashion world. As you can see here, I took the knitting trend and put it in a veggie knitting pattern. Or here, the illustration with the lace apples again from the lace trend from fashion. You can even take that further and you go to repeats based on food. So food patterns. And I'm not the first one who did that, because Dolce & Gabbana did a total collection in the spring 2012 collection with veggie food patterns, as you can see. Onions, peppers, tomatoes, everything. So, very nice. And yesterday morning in the papers, I saw that Frankie Morello in his new collection has fast food patterns. So, big item. Okay, last project I wanted to talk, because here all food and fashion comes together for me. I started Comida Cuisine, named after the youngest kitchen help in the kitchen. And it's a sustainable kitchen textile brand, in which I have just tea towels and napkins, but the illustrations are based on fashion designs. Also, I wanted to take the aprons, the apron a step further, not just being an item that covers you up when you're cooking for protection, but also something you can wear in your own way, and you can change the way of wearing it. In the kitchen, you cover it up, and as you're eating your dinner, you pull it down and your own outfit shows. So, at Comida Cuisine, the story behind it is very important. You can all see it on my website, but what was a very nice detail is that we promote stains, because I think stains, give something extra to your kitchen textiles, because it reminds you of a nice dinner or a nice, exactly, the fight sometimes. And also, on the other side, you don't have to wash your textiles on a high temperature, so it's better for the environment. So, oh yeah, if you like aprons, you really should go to Arnhem this summer, because there's an exposition by Lidewa Edekort, and go see it. Okay, well, this is the end of my presentation, almost, because I wanted to say to you, let's swap place, which means, I think, because a lot of people say, well, don't look too much at other people, stay with yourself, but I think you should go and see everything and everyone, and you should listen, you should eat, you should drink, And you should get inspired, take it all in, never copy literally, but you use it to create your own thing. So, that's the message. And let's live tastefully ever after.